what you're looking at here is a mutton snapper is about to undergo a surgical procedure where we're going to implant an acoustical tag into the abdominal cavity. And this acoustical tag will tell us where the fish is, and some of our tags will even tell us how deep the fish is when the signal from the pinger tag is sent to our receivers. My name is Mike Feely. I'm a fisheries biologist with the State of Florida Fish and Wildlife Commission. We hope to find out, you know, where these fish go, or in fact, if they just stay resident at the home. The fish is placed upside down. The fish seems to relax in this position, and we cover its eyes and its head, and that seems to, the fish just sits there for us, doesn't panic. So we're taking this approach to do these surgeries underwater, primarily because it's easier on the fish and the fish's health and its ability to recover. And mud snapper are particularly susceptible to barotrauma. When you catch them at depth, their swim bladders expand so fast it can kill them. So doing the surgery underwater enables the fish to recover quickly. This project here is looking at commercially important species, the mutton snapper, which uses Rileys to spawn from approximately April to August every year. They gather in large numbers out here. So we're interested in finding out where the fish are coming from and where they're going to, and how long they're staying at the aggregation, and trying to determine how many times an individual fish would spawn. So here the divers are placing the pinger tag into the abdominal cavity. We put in a couple sutures, two or three sutures, to help that incision heal up, and then the fish is released. So here the fish has come out of the surgery, and pretty much they're ready to go right after the incision is sewn up. And we'll immediately start collecting data on that fish. We placed 9 receivers around Riley's home, and we'll be able to track that fish for a period of about 2 years. The battery life of these tags is about 2 years, so we hope to see these fish return to this spawning site the following year.